grace abounding, right?
Yeah.
So he says here, verse 1, what shall we say then? Shall we continue in sin that grace may abound?
Right.
Because grace abounds where there is a lot of sin, there's a lot of grace.
Okay?
So he says in verse 2, God forbid, in other words, I don't think so. How shall we that are dead to sin live any longer in sin? Know ye not that so many of us that were baptized into Jesus Christ were baptized into his death? Therefore we are buried with him in baptism unto death, that like as Christ was raised up from the dead by the glory of the Father, even so we also should walk in newness of life. An extended definition of grace. We know it as undeserved, unmerited favor, right?
Yes.
But an extended definition in the New Testament, in the New Covenant, is not only is it undeserved favor, First Lady, but it's influence in my heart.
All right.
The grace of God is supposed to influence my heart to want to change.
Yes.
Influence in the heart that is reflected in the life.
Amen.
That's how I know that I can really give God praise for his grace. When grace affects me, it affects my life. It affects the way that I live. Grace comes to produce righteousness in us. And we can judge our own self. Nobody else got to judge us. According to the word, I got to know, have I really received the grace of God? It's available to all men through Jesus Christ. But have I really received the grace? Have I really taken advantage of this grace? Because if I have, my life changed. I'm in pursuit of righteousness. Righteousness is being produced in my life now instead of sin, because the grace has abounded. Where there is sin, the grace is more plentiful. So there is more righteousness than sin. Grace of God brings us to salvation. How does a person receive Christ? How does a person get saved? The word of God comes and it's got to influence their heart to even realize that they need a Savior. You got to realize that you need to change. You got to realize that I'm not in right standing with God. If I don't have God's spirit, if I don't have a relationship with him, I'm not in the right place with God. Go to Romans, the 8th chapter.
That's good.
We talk about, we all God's children, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Romans, the 8th chapter. It's so much in here, but I don't have time. So let's just go to it. Let's just go to, oh God, verse 5. No, let's go to verse 1. I said
Amen.
I wanted to do this. Romans 8 and 1. And I'm almost through, y'all, for real. Romans, the 8th chapter. There is therefore now no condemnation to them which are in Christ Jesus, who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit. Now, this is for the folk that have come into Christ, that have been born again. We are no longer condemned, but if we walk after the Spirit, there's no condemnation to them which are in Christ, and then there's a comma, who walk not after the flesh, but after the spirit. So that means that if I'm in Christ and still walking in my flesh and carnality, then I'm still condemned. Verse 2, for the law of the spirit of life in Christ Jesus has made me law from made me free from the law of sin and death. Listen, because Adam sinned, we were all condemned to death, right? Can we agree on that? Okay. There was a law in place that, because God spoke it, there was a law put in motion to make sure that sin gonna always produce death. Sin gonna produce death. That's why Jesus couldn't die, because he didn't sin. They beat his flesh and killed his flesh, but his soul, he really couldn't die because there was no sin, and he was subject to the law of sin and death, but he was not under the law of sin and death. Okay, then we got two things working here. We talked about the law of Moses, right? The Mosaic law, the rules and the regulations and the statutes and all of that that God gave Moses in the wilderness to govern the people. And then there's the law of sin and death. What the law of sin and death does, everyone that is not born again, every man that was born after Adam was born with a law working in his members. We don't have time to go into chapter 7, but just read chapter 7. You know what Paul was talking about? When I would do good, evil is always present. And I find a law working in my members, bringing me into captivity. You know? Because there's something working in you that's called the law of sin and death. It works in every person that is not born of God's spirit. I don't care how good you are. I don't care how morally good you are. I don't care how much you come to church. You got something working with you. There's something working with you. There's a law working in your members that causes you to sin. You can't help.
Walk after the flesh
and And walking in carnality is the same thing. Now, you can be a born-again Christian, or you can be an unsaved person, actually, to walk in the flesh. Because you can be saved and still walk in the flesh. You can have God's spirit in you and still walk after the flesh. The dictates of your flesh. Your flesh telling you what to do. Those that are born again and have the spirit of God living in them are supposed to be governed by the spirit of God. We're supposed to be led by God. Our lives is given over to God. We belong to God now. You heard the song, I'm not my own, I belong to God. I belong to God now. He governs my life. He tells me what to do. I got to deny myself and take up my cross and follow him. Take over, we claim, declare, decree and declare, baby.